Hello, everybody. Let's bring my streams up on my computer so that way I can look at the comments when I sit down. Gonna be drawing see, let me fix something real quick on here. All right, I think we're all set. So today, I gotta be quiet here because this is drawing is going to be actually a gift for my sister for Christmas. We're gonna be drawing Gene Kelly from what's it called? Singing in the Rain. And there's this drawing, if you guys remember from my last podcast, I had to redraw this on watercolor paper. So I don't want to waste this big piece of Bristol board. So we'll just use the other side for the drawing. So I don't think I'm gonna need any of my architecture stuff today, like my T square or anything like that, but I'll keep it out just in case. Because you never know. We'll just put that over here and we'll adjust the camera so you guys can see the whole thing. It's gonna be a pretty big drawing. There we go. And let's get some music going. This is pretty much gonna be just copied off of some clip art or something. Cleaning this up. I want this to be a very clean canvas here to work on. Actually, this would actually work better like this. So you You guys are gonna have to come up a little bit higher here with the camera. And the light. Okay, that should be good. I will probably need my T-square. Oops, dang it. There we go. So we got the two. Going to need something like that, and then don't really need to be that angle, doesn't need to be anything too extreme here. See how that looks for now, and then actually let's change that. I don't like it. Let's actually draw him in to see how measure those out, his legs out real quick to make sure I get them right. Foot break there. I think all these really are going to need to come in closer to the, yeah, because this arm is too long, so this all needs to kind of come in closer here. I want them to be bigger. A lot of canvas space. I don't want to have too much negative space. Okay, I think that's, I think that'll be okay. Thank you. He's gonna be in that suit anyway, so you don't really gotta worry about too much of this. Rib cage. Alright. Head. Gene Kelly's got a pretty strong jawline, so hat on, we'll get the hat later. Have the ball right there. Groundwork laid in for the designs. All right. That's gonna kind of have a point to it. kind of in power shoulders with this jacket. Get like the creases in his pants. This is gonna hug his side a little bit more here. Let's kind of refine this. Okay. I think we're about ready for the okay, so now that we're going to go over this with the finishing pencil. Keep. this over here. Kind of a design on his coat too. I don't know if I'm feeling the face. I might have him put his head back just a little bit more. Folds in his pants in. A lot of this is going to be blacked out too. Guess my Facebook live stream cut out again. I don't know why it keeps doing that. Sorry, guys. Well, anyways. Before I black out the shadows on him, let's redo his head. It looks good, but it doesn't... I want his head to be tilted back farther. So let's do this here. Because the shot from the movie has him more... his head back more. Make it too small or too big. We want a nice... There we go. Because his coat kind of covers part of his. Guideline, we're gonna break that down and make that a little bit more. Because let's get the center line first. So the center line's gonna be like that, facing straight on. So that means we're gonna do something like that. His ear's gonna be all the way down here. His head is gonna be like that, and then his other ear's gonna be right there, but you're not really gonna see that one. He's got kind of a really masculine, strong jawline, Gene Kelly does, so... And his hat kind of comes down. probably fix his hat up after. Let me see. Does his head look a little too big? I don't think so. To look like he's screaming in pain or anything like that, so jawline and early. Let's see if we can get this hat right on him too. Shape of the hat's still bothering me here. I think I got that side right. Alright, I think that's way better. Okay. Make sure I got this measured out correctly. Oh, that arm is gonna be way, this arm is way too long, we can see. Or is it? Hold on. Oh yeah, this is gonna be, this arm needs to get shortened up a bit. This arm I think is okay. Where is this one? Yeah, I think this one's okay, but this one I think needs to get shortened up just a little bit. The shadows in here, okay. Let's do a shoe down here. So there's other shoes coming out the other side. I'll take a little bit of creative liberties here. not good. Dang it. Where's my... Looking for my circle template. Oh, here it is. Having things disappear on me. With this. Okay. I think the interior lines I could probably just get with the, look at that with the brush when I go over it. think that looks good. Okay, so now what I'm going to do, before I do the final shadows or anything, and I start inking, let me turn this around to see if I can see any kind of oddities. I'm looking at it through the light that I got hanging up here. Trying to look at it and just see if I can see any kind of oddities before I make it final. I think I'm going to need to make this a little bit more. I do want him to look like he's smiling a little bit as he's. There we go, that does look a lot better. Okay, so let's block in the shadows here. Actually, things like that, I think, are what make it look a little bit better. Give him a little bit of a muscular leg since he was a dancer, so. Okay. Just going to lay in some shadows here with the pencil. Just to see how they look before inking. Thank you. Alright, doesn't look too bad. Actually, I think I'll do this whole thing black, and then I'll go over with some lines of the white out after. I think that would make that look really cool. Could even do a we'll see about doing that, like a little shadow or something. So let's start inking this and put away my pencils here. We'll start out with the smallest zebra brush pen I got. And we'll do the outside. So you guys keep seeing the top of my head. Alright, let's do Here, based on what side the light's going to be hitting. So it's going to have a way heavier line on it. Putting my little X's in here. Design that kind of goes across his jacket here. Thank you. Okay. Okay. All right. Let's go with a Pigma Micron for the outline here instead of a brush pen. Go with a I want to go with a really thin one for the ball here. I'm sorry guys that my head keeps getting in the way. My crazy hair. Let's do this here. Let's zoom this in. Hopefully this helps a little bit. I'm gonna have to move this down because I really want to make sure I get this one right. Okay. So I got the orb down, the light. Let's do... let's do a 0.8 here because I really want to make this thing look solid. This looks like I'm drawing a little face on there. Okay. So I don't know how I feel about the shadow, but we'll see. Okay. Let me get this air out real quick before I erase it. This side of the drawing here. Really make sure this is clean because you can't erase anymore after you lay down the flat inks because you'll smudge them pretty badly. Okay. Get my brush out. Testing paper. See how my about my Pentel Pocket brush pen. Maybe that might work a little bit better. Yeah, they work both about the same. We'll keep both of them on hand. Yeah, I still have a full cap full in this one. Make sure you guys can see everything. All right, let's start. So I think, yeah, this one will be okay. Brush tip. Okay, I think that's okay. This black around his head is really going to make his head pop. Oh yeah, the inside of his mouth too. Okay. Okay. Okay, we are done inking on him. So let's start on this, on the lamp post. Thank you, there be a bee. Or there a bee. Thank you. Appreciate the kind words. Thank you. So let's see here. Kind of let this feather out here. Okay. So let's do this here. It's blowing on it to try to get the, make sure everything's nice and dry before I go on and do this part. White out here. Alright, so we're just going to do some, let's maybe do this from the side here. We could start at the top. I don't want to show every single line here, just some of them. Just enough to kind of let these dance along here and really some of these are kind of go a little bit longer here, so you're gonna want it to look like tree bark. So thank you. All right, I think that doesn't look too bad. Let's see here. I think at this point it might be ready to sign. Something right down here in the corner. That is it for this tonight's art stream. Thank you all who were watching. I hope you enjoyed it. And I will be back tomorrow with my Cyberpunk stream. Let me just kind of clean up some of this stuff here. And I hope you guys will be around to watch that. So anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys tomorrow for Cyberpunk. And you guys have a happy holidays. Take care.